Everyone, our topic today is testing, assessing and teaching. Here we'll see what's the difference between testing and assessing and what teaching is. Test anxiety is a natural phenomena. When we encounter the word test, we get worried, we get conscious about our capabilities, we think that am I good enough? Will my performance be good? For example, in this picture, the girl has put on her head and she is worried about her performance. She is worried about her results. So it's natural that when you have to appear for a test or when you encounter the word test, the anxiety gets prevailed. The test can be defined as that it's a method of measuring a person's ability, knowledge or performance in a given domain. So there are four things that it's a method, it measures something, it measures a person's ability, knowledge or performance, and it is this performance is measured in a given domain. So let's discuss one by one all these things. The test is a method. So test is a set of techniques, procedures or items. It may be explicit or it may be structured. When it is structured, it may be in the form of multiple choice questions with prescribed correct answers, or it may be a writing prompt with a scoring rubric. It may take a form of an oral interview based on question scripts, and it may be a checklist of expected responses to be filled in by the administration. The next thing about test is that it measures. Rather, it must measure something. What it measures, it may be general ability of a person or it may be specific competencies, objectives or knowledge. For example, if a test measures someone's general ability, it may be a multi-skill proficiency test. And if we have to measure specific competencies or we have some specific objectives or we have to test knowledge, so the test may be in the form of quiz on recognizing correct use of definite articles. These are the examples of measuring. A test measures performance. It may be linguistic competencies or it may be knowledge about language. When we talk about language test and we are going to assess linguistic competencies, then we assess the performance of someone regarding four skills of language like speaking, writing, reading and listening. And when we have to assess someone's knowledge about language, so we design a test to measure his or her performance regarding vocabulary, grammar rules, to identify a rhetorical feature in written discourse, etc. Test measures a specific domain. For example, when it positively measures specific domain, then it will include specific topics to measure the desired criterion. But when it doesn't measure some specific domain, then it may include factors inadvertently. Now let's discuss what assessing is. What's the difference between test and assessment? So test is prepared administrative procedures that occurs at identifiable times. So there are specific times when tests are given or taken. But assessment is an ongoing process. It keeps on, it goes on. For example, students respond to a question. When you are in a class and you ask a question and a student responds to that question, that is assessment. On the response of your student, you may offer a comment that would be assessment. Sometimes a student tries out a new word and you give your response, that is assessment. Sometimes students tries out a new structure, so that is assessment. So assessment may be by teacher or it may be by the student himself or herself, or it may be done by other students too. As we have previously discussed that assessment is an ongoing process, and every teacher subconsciously or unconsciously makes an assessment of the student's performance while he or she answers a question, offers a comment, tries to speak or produce something new during the class. A good teacher never ceases to assess students. He always offers comments, he always gives response to their questions, and it is assessment. But teaching is a conscious process of giving instruction. It provides opportunities for learners to listen, think, take risks, set goals, and process feedback from the coach to improve their learning process. It also provides observations in students' performance. So we can conclude that assessment is an ongoing process, while it is unconscious process, but the teaching is a conscious process of giving instruction. Let's discuss the difference between tests and assessment. When we talk about tests, they are prepared administrative procedures. They are not unconscious procedures. They are prepared administrative procedures, and they occur at identifiable times in a curriculum. There is a specific time when tests are given or taken. So learners muster all their faculties. They are conscious about their performance, so they try to do their best in their test. Learners' responses are being measured and evaluated. The learners know that their responses are being measured and evaluated. So we can say that tests are subset of assessment. But when we talk about assessment, it's an ongoing process. It encompasses a much wider domain. Tests are a part of assessment. In assessment on each aspect about students, the teacher makes assessment on students' performance. Test is one procedure among the other procedures of assessment. There may be many other procedures and tasks in assessment that are different from tests to assess students. This diagram displays the relationship among teaching, assessing, and testing. So the goal of teaching is to develop skill, competence, to make performance better. And the goal of assessing is to give feedback for improvement. Actually, assessing is an informal tool. It leads to evaluation, which is analytical tool and formal tool. Maybe a formal tool to give feedback for improvement in the skill, competence, and performance. While the testing's goal is to assign a level or grade and to pass judgment whether the student is passed or failed. But in this diagram, one thing that is evaluation. Because all these things, test, assessing, teaching, and evaluation are interrelated, so evaluation must be there in this proposed. We'll discuss what's the difference between informal and formal assessment. Actually, informal assessment is designed to elicit performance without regarding results and making a fixed judgments about a student's performance. There is no fixed judgment about students' performance. There is no recording of results. It's done in an informal way. These are the examples of informal assessment. For example, at the end of continuum are marginal comments on paper given by the teacher. So these marginal comments on the paper are the form of informal assessment. When the teacher responds to draft of an essay, he or she advises of how to better pronounce a word, when a teacher gives suggestions for a strategy, showing how to modify a better note taking to better remember of the lecture contents. So these are the examples of informal assessment. So this diagram displays the forms of informal assessment. For example, when a teacher says good job, you have done a great job, these comments are a form of informal assessment. There may be other forms like incidental unplanned comments and responses of the teacher are informal assessment, coaching, impromptu feedback, marginal comments on papers, responding to a draft of an essay, are advising about how to better pronounce words, are suggestions given by the teacher are the forms of informal. Assessment is designed to tap into storehouse of skill and knowledge. These are constructed to give an appraisal of students' achievement. A question arises that is a formal assessment always a test? The answer is that all tests are formal assessments, but all formal assessments are not tests. We conclude that formal assessments are systematic, planned sampling techniques. And these are constructed to give teacher and students an appraisal of students' achievement. We'll discuss the difference between formative and summative assessment. Formative assessment deals with the function. Its purpose is to evaluate students in the process of forming their competencies and skills. And the goal of formative assessment is to help the students to continue in the process of their growth. So there are certain characteristics of formative assessment. These are as follows, that it is delivered by the teacher and feedbacks are internalized by the students. Teacher gives feedback and these feedbacks are internalized by the students. It eyes towards the future continuation and it takes the form of informal assessment. So, evaluating students in the process of forming their competencies and skills represents formative assessment. Formative assessment occurs every time and it is delivered by the teacher and internalized by the students. And all kinds of informal assessments are formative assessments. Formative assessment focuses on the ongoing development of the learner's language. The aim of summative assessment is to measure or to summarize what a student has grasped, what he has achieved. So a summation means that we have to look back and take stock of how well a student has accomplished his or her objectives. As the summative assessment measures or summarizes what a student has grasped, so it occurs at the end of a course unit or instruction. There are some examples of summative tests. These may be in the form of general proficiency exams. It may take the form of quizzes, or it may be in the form of periodic review tests. Midterm exams are also a form of summative assessment. Now we have to discuss norm-referenced and criterion-referenced tests. And what is the difference between norm-referenced and criterion-referenced tests? In norm-referenced tests, scores are interpreted in relation to a mean, median, standard deviation, and or in percentile rank. While the criterion-referenced tests are designed to give test takers feedback in the form of grades on specific course or lesson objectives. The purpose of norm reference tests is to place test takers along a mathematical continuum in a rank orders. And scores are reported back to the test taker in form of numerical scores, while feedback is given in the form of grades in criterion reference tests. The norm reference tests are administered to large audiences, and the responses are already predetermined. But the criterion reference tests require much time and effort from the teacher or test administrators, while appropriate feedback is given in these tests. According to Oler 1979, instructional value of criterion reference test is another important characteristics of these tests. The scholastic aptitude test and test of foreign test of English as a foreign language are the examples of norm reference tests, while classroom tests involving the students on only one class and connected to a curriculum are the example of criterion reference tests. Thank you very much.